For homicide detectives, the clock starts ticking the moment they are called.
How do you know it's a dead body there? You strangled her?
Good Lord.
And one of the bottles been there for 3 weeks.
All we've got is 6 dead bodies, and we don't know anything about the suspect.
Their chance of solving a murder is cut in half.
Sister shook me with his hand.
If they don't get a lead,
he was going to kill us one by one.
Within the first 48 hours.
You going to call us back tomorrow with more bodies?
It's unbelievable. This is unbelievable. We have a serial killer.
PM Thursday, the end of a long, hot Kansas City summer.
Homicide, Niemeyer.
Sergeant Doug Niemeyer gets called out to a bizarre scene in the Prospect Avenue area, a working-class neighborhood with numerous abandoned houses.
A neighbor smelled something last week when he was mowing the grass out there. Today, somebody went inside this garage and they found 2 bodies stacked on top of each other.
Intelligent, articulate, and handsome. A young man on the fast track to success.
He looked like a young Cary Grant.
Yet during a grisly killing spree that spanned 5 years, Ted Bundy slaughtered more than 35 women.
From his point of view, the thing that would make for good sex is an attractive woman whom he's going to handcuff, terrorize, and make her believe that she's going to die.
After 8 months' painstaking work, the investigators have their man.
Of course, when we arrested the killer, we were all very satisfied.
Investigators are now able to piece together Marina's last moments. She'd met Pichushkin on June the 13th. He'd asked her out for a picnic in the park.
He said, I was sitting there with her for a very long time, really long, wondering whether to kill her or not. And eventually I decided to kill her because I felt that if I didn't, life would become torture for me.
Ressler began his career as a military investigator for the U.S. Army. He was stationed in Europe and the Far East. In the Army, he learned how to catch criminals.
I became convinced that understanding the motives of the killer would ultimately make me better at catching them. So I started studying psychology and continued as a criminal investigator.
Upon leaving the Army, Robert Ressler was looking for a way to achieve his goal.
I wanted to work for the best, and that was the FBI. Here I thought I could combine my knowledge of criminal behavior and psychology. I was especially interested in serial killers because here I thought psychology played a major role in why they killed and how.
Tonight on the Fifth Estate, an unprecedented moment in Canadian crime and justice as it took place and is seen by people who know what happens in the mind of a killer.
Right. Well, again, Russell, I appreciate you coming in an investigation like this. I mean, I'm sure you can appreciate it's been big news, especially down Belleville way.
It started with the police interrogator's version of small talk.
We're fast-forwarding things that we might normally take our time with, and that's why we're here on a Sunday afternoon. So, again, I appreciate it.
And I'm quite sure at that point, it's in everybody's mind, he's not walking out that door a free man that night.
For a while, there was denial.
Okay. Have you ever visited Marie Franz Como at her residence?
No.
Okay. All right. So you're quite positive there would be no reason why your DNA would be in any of those three locations?
Now, what he's doing is trying to figure out an explanation to give this guy. Because he knows, man, I am screwed. I am so screwed.
It would come down to the two men in the room, the commanding officer and the detective.
Your vehicle drove up the side of Jessica Lloyd's house. Your boots walked to the back of Jessica Lloyd's house on the evening of the 28th and 29th of January. You want discretion. We need to have some honesty, okay? Because this is getting out of control really fast.
Lee was born in 1956 in Troy, Michigan. 3 months later, she was abandoned by her mother. In 1963, her father committed suicide in prison. He was serving a sentence for sodomizing a 7-year-old child. Tyria Moore represented the most stable relationship in her life.
Do you understand the nature of the charge?
Yes, I do, sir.
Do you wish to be represented by counsel?
Yes, I do.
Can you afford to hire an attorney?
No, sir.
Do you work?
No. I'm in jail. How can I work?
Well, obviously you're not working now, but how long has it been since you last worked?
About 84, possibly.
You hadn't worked in 6 or 7 years? How do you support yourself?
I was a professional call girl.
Do you own any property here in the state of Florida? You own a motor vehicle of any kind?
Pardon?
You own a motor vehicle of any kind?
No, sir.
If you'll sign an affidavit, I will appoint the public defender to represent you. And Ms. Warnes, you've been ordered in this warrant to be held without bail. That will be my order.
This has always been known as a city of mystery, and it seems now to have a new and real one on its hands. 5 murders, and somebody who says he committed all and will commit yet more.
The search goes on Channel 13 in San Francisco for the man known as the Zodiac Killer. The elements involved today...
Zodiac, a symbol that now stands for terror in San Francisco. Today there was a possibly significant development in the terrifying case of the man who calls himself Zodiac.
The psychotic killer has already murdered 5. One at a lover's lane near a lake just north of San Francisco. 3 others in nearby Vallejo. The latest, a taxi driver in San Francisco.
Cluster builder Frederick West, his wife Rosemary, and the house that hid a dark secret. The bodies of 5 young women in the cellar, 1 more in the bathroom. In the garden where his children played, 3 more young women lay, including a teenage daughter. The world looked on in horror as family man Fred West was charged with a spree of kidnap, rape, sex crime and murder that cost 12 young lives.
Back in 1972, the Willowbrook State School was the subject of a famous expose by a young reporter looking for his big break.
I first heard of this big place with the pretty sounding name because of a call I received from a member of the Willowbrook staff, Dr. Michael Wilkins. The doctor invited me to see the conditions he was talking about, so unannounced and unexpected by the school administration, we toured building number 6. The doctor had warned me that it would be bad. It was horrible. There was one attendant for perhaps 50 severely and profoundly retarded children. Lying on the floor, naked and smeared with their own feces, they were making a pitiful sound, a kind of mournful wail that it's impossible for me to forget. This is what it looked like, this is what it sounded like, but how can I tell you about the way it smelled? It smelled of filth, it smelled of disease, and it smelled of death.
It's actually pretty hard to help Eileen, who by now, not surprisingly, doesn't trust anyone. And she's threatening to fire her lawyer if he continues to try to fight the execution. Dawn told Eileen about our visit to Troy, and Eileen asked for the opportunity to put the record straight about her childhood.
All right. Yep. Will you let me know when she is? Okay. You don't have any secret cameras in your belt, eh?
No, I just have this rather large one right here.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing all right. How you doing?
Good.
Check out the orange shirt.
Wasn't it orange? Was it orange before?
No, they changed it. They got this new thing that to wear the orange shirt out for rec or wherever, whenever you get out of your cell. Like death row has never escaped. Nobody on death row has ever escaped, right? And they're acting like we're escape riskers.
What's it like being in here all the time?
What's it like being in here? Well, here it's okay. It's all right. But, you know, you have your problems with some staff don't like you, Jess. Oh, you're a serial killer!